Hi, I'm Miss Lampke, and we are going to be looking at the distances between our planets using a scale model. Today we're going to be using toilet paper to create that scale model. On this model, every inch represents 7,710,000 miles. So that means like from here to here, 7,710,000 miles, 7,710,000 miles, so on and so forth, right? So now we're starting to think about how far away these planets are from the sun. Talk amongst your groups really quickly. Where do you think every other planet is in that distance? Go.
Earth, Mars.
Hey, now you guys are starting to think about that scale, right? Because that scale is 7,710,000 miles. So initially you guys are probably like, oh, it's maybe 100,000 miles away. But now that scale is getting bigger and bigger. So when we go out there, you and your group mates are going to get a piece of tape. And I'm gonna give you all a marker as well. What you are going to do is you're gonna think how far away is Pluto with our door being the sun, okay? From then, you all are all going to mark the other 8 planets in our solar system, starting with Mercury, okay? So if you put Pluto really, really far away, you gotta think about, well, where are all those other planets going to line up? I want you and your group to kind of figure out where do you think Pluto is going to be. I'm going to give each team a roll of toilet paper. The first square is going to be the sun, and you're gonna start it right here on this black line, okay? As you keep going down, you're gonna figure out, okay, where's Mercury? Then you're gonna stop and you're gonna draw Mercury and label it. I'm going to give you a key to help you out. See if your predictions were a little off or pretty close. There you go. As you draw your planets, markers are the easiest to use, but be careful that you don't rip one. See what I did there? Note that the planet drawings are not to scale. On this scale, the planets would be very, very small, too small for us to draw. Teachers, you can adapt this activity to include math by only giving students the distances to the planets. Then have them calculate the number of squares of toilet paper based on the distance to Mercury being 1 square. Earth is 2.5. Mars is 3. Then you get all the way up to Jupiter and it's 12 squares out. Quietly and carefully come back into the room, back to your spot, and we're gonna discuss some things. How was your prediction different or similar to what you actually got? Alice, what did your group find?
It was very far off.
Very far off. Is there anything that you know that is in our solar system that was missing from your model? Shion?
The moon.
The moons, right? We know that not just Earth has moons, but a whole bunch of other planets have moons, right? One last thing I want to leave you guys with. How would our model change if we maybe did this with another galaxy? Would we need a lot more toilet paper or the same amount? Wes?
We're gonna need a lot more.
That's a lot of toilet paper.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.